this story is about a lot of development for Bella. Not only does she lose the love of her life, and the character that she is, she's not someone who changes her mind about something once she decides on it. Not just that, but she had picked her future as well. She had already decided, I'm going to be a vampire. This is going to be my family. There were costs that needed to be paid, but sometimes when someone tells you you can't have something, as Edward has told her many times, you stop looking at the consequences. You get very single-minded about getting to the goal, and then you'll deal with the aftermath. And she's really in that place at the beginning of New Moon. She just wants to get to her goal. And when Edward leaves, he takes her plan for the future and everything she wanted. And it's very difficult for her because she doesn't really recover. She starts too slowly, but she's always a little bit elsewhere because, you know, the love of her life and the future she wanted are gone. So her development was really interesting. It was painful to write. The Volturi had to exist because, as I went ahead with the series, the Colons were fairly omnipotent. I mean, they were the strongest, and there were a lot of them, and you didn't want it to be like Superman, you know, where there's never a bad guy that's really a match for him. So I needed a really powerful bad guy, and I looked at the vampire world the way it was in my head, and who would be in charge there, and how they would be, and they came to life pretty easily for me. When I started on New Moon, Jacob was intrinsic to the plot from the beginning, and it wasn't so much that he was another boy to help Bella get over Edward. He was just one of those friends that, you know, sometimes there's people who are so happy that you can't really be totally miserable around them, and that's what pulls her in, is his happiness. And then by the time he's not as happy and he has some rough things to do, it's sort of flipped around, and she feels the need to take care of him. And I really enjoyed writing about the relationship because it was very different from hers and Edward's. That was the fairy tale romance, sweep you off your feet. And this was about people becoming best friends and really loving each other in a different way. The Wolf Pack was really cool. That was one of the most fun days I've had on set, was hanging out with them, because they really are, they're a bunch of teenage boys. And they're just that much fun, and they were so the characters. They just were having fun, just like the characters would be. And then they'd get on set, and they just sounded exactly right. They sounded really real. It wasn't like anyone was acting. They were just being themselves, and so that was really cool. And they looked beautiful together. I am so proud of Taylor. You know, he was great in Twilight, but, you know, he was the happy kid there. And there's so much more to Jacob. And so I think the question, it wasn't so much, can he get huge? It was, does he have that darkness? And he is such an actor. I was really impressed when I first saw what he was capable of. Wow. And I think people, when they see this movie, are just, I mean, he's going to be huge. He's amazing. It's fascinating to watch Mensa because he is raw. And he's hilarious, and you'll see him laughing and then, you know, set action, and all of a sudden he looks different. He actually, his face looks different. He gets so deeply into character that you have to drop of a hat. It's, and then cut, and he's Rob again. It's really fascinating to watch that.